hasn't scored since the opening bucket of the game, and that was on a fast break. And Ray Allen has it rejected. And Cage goes out into the good seats. He's scattering people.
Ray Allen really is finding life really tough against this club.
0 for his last 13 from the floor for Ray Allen.
Pretty tough to win when your big star goes 0 for 13. College score picked him as the player of the year.
And Otella Harrington trying to stay with Durant Sheffield. Otella's been playing tough tonight, maybe a little bit tired, couldn't make the move, we're going to pick up the foul. Ricky Moore is the only Husky to score from the field for UConn in the last 11 minutes.
And that's amazing. When you talk about guys like Sheffield and Allen, one of the best backcourts in America, they have to find a way to make some shots. They got to be the leaders, especially against big-time competition like Georgetown. You know, talking about player of the year, College Sports Magazine, outstanding magazine, picked Ray Allen as player of the year. My choice is certainly going to be Mr. Marcus Camby. I think what Camby has done with that team down there, leading that club to an incredible record. Incredible. I think right now they're 30-1, and that is just unbelievable, Massachusetts.
Under 6 minutes, and a 6-point game for the Hoyas.
Hoyas still hanging in there. Now, here's Ricky Moore at the front of the 1-3-1 trap. Going to try and take him to a win. The Iverson to the left side.
69-63. And Georgetown's going to spread it a little bit.
They want to get good spacing against that. You want to set up a guy at the high post and look opposite. The Heidi White will be open on the opposite side.
Down the shot clock, not under the 8 as Othello Harrington goes strong and got the roll. He's having a good game. 13 for Harrington, the senior.
And the cheering of Mr. Ewing. Great execution by John Squad attacking that half court clock.
Sheffield doesn't have a 3 tonight. Ray Allen. To Ricky Moore. Trying to tip it in, no good. And Othello Harrington, the senior, said, you know what? This is my last Big East tournament game. I'm going to play tonight.
And he wants that Big East championship win. And he has played. Now going to play man-to-man. Moore matched up with Iverson. Jumper up his.
Thompson just gave him the 4 fingers down low. And that's what they ran last night into Heidi White.
They are really executing, Brad. They are really playing well. They're playing as well as any Georgetown team I have seen in terms of their half-court execution. They're using dribble penetration. They're spreading the floor. They're doing a number of different things that are effective.
And they're using those 4 guys down on the baseline like they did last night. They did it there, and it pays off again.
Well, what they do by simply placing the 4, they open up the court for their drivers. And guys like Page, there's an example. He drives, he draws, and he dishes the rock. Makes like the 3D man. Great execution, but better than that, discipline and managing each possession intelligently.
Travis Knight fouls out with 4:46 left. So there goes some more of the inside presence now for the Huskies, and they're down 10, and Jahadi White can make it 11 if he hits this free throw.
Wow, wow, where's the foul? Where's the foul?
Williams out, and Al comes in.
I was looking at the ISO before I said, where's the foul? There's one looking at it right here. I don't know, you see a foul? I don't see a foul in that situation.
A lot of times I don't see it.
Well, I got one eye, so I can't really think. Rex can look at me and see me. So what are you talking about? You got one eye. You can't see.
Ray Allen hasn't scored, but it seems like forever. Cross-court pass. Ricky Moore, the only last scorer this game in the second half for UConn, and now 13.
But if he's not scoring, he's making a great pass. There it is. It's a tremendous look to the interior. Ricky Moore is so good that he's a big-time point guard. They've got 1-4 set up again. Spacing, isolation, pressure now on Sheffield to beat Page when he starts his dribble penetration. But bringing it in, they utilize and manage the shot clock.
They work it down near 10 before Page will start to make a move, and we're under 4 minutes in the game. Iverson had a look, and Moore picked him off. Now he's going to have to push one. Page will at the buzzer of the shot clock, and it rolled out. And a foul on Ja underneath, trying to get the rebound. And that, I believe, will be it for Yaya as well. Ja fouls out with 3:45 to go, and the Hoyas holding on to a 74-65 lead. The King, he He's had a big game offensively. 15 for him tonight.
Connecticut's going to have to make something happen with their